Namaskar. One question that is repeatedly asked is, what is the right time to exercise? My answer is very simple. Whenever you can do it, is the right time. Wrong time is better than no time. So even if you intend to do it at midnight, perfectly okay. But if you're already into it and asking which is the best time, then my recommendation would be that it should be early in the morning. Wake up your body, because at night, every part of your body is in the resting mode. You have to snap it back into the active mode. And rest period, the synovial fluid around all your joints also becomes more thick, and if you don't recirculate it properly, it'll cause you problems. The nearest example is that of a car. You can do an experiment during the winter months. Most of the cars these days have a RPM meter. When you give it a cold start, you will find that the engine is at about 1500 revolutions per minute. And as you run the engine idle for some time, it comes down to 700 and 800. That is the right time for you to drive off. But what happens is we ignite it and immediately get going. So car is a little jerky for a few seconds. But by the time you reach the next turn, things get normal. We think that it wasn't warm enough and now everything is fine. No, it is not that simple. Research has found that 70 to 80% of the microscopic damage to your engine happens in those first few seconds. In exactly the same way, if we don't warm up the body early in the morning, then it will be running heavy for the whole day. So if you can warm up the body as soon as you get up, it will be much better. Then your heart rate would be low, your pulse rate would be telling you this thing that I'm not having to put in too much of effort. As you probably must have tried, those people who do not exercise have a very fast pulse rate, whereas those who are into active sports, remarkably low pulse rate. What that means is that in the case of a person with a sedentary life, the heart is having to work harder just to keep the body moving. His heart would be beating as if somebody is running. So for him, even the sitting job is as tough as running, besides the aches and pains it causes. So early morning is the best time. What happens is that we have so many joints in the body and they have to be taken to their maximum limit on a daily basis. If you stretch them to their maximum limit every day, then that fluidity of movement remains. If you don't, one, you cannot take it to that extremity, and secondly, it will cause aches and pains in that body part. For example, this hand is meant to come to this, move to this spot. If you don't move it, I mean, we keep on reducing the movement, what will happen is that it will be very difficult for us to take it to the extreme limit. Same happens with your shoulders. We don't move our shoulders, the result is that in a later stage of life, we may have frozen shoulder. So, to ensure that it is the early morning time when we have to wake up every part so that the synovial fluid starts flowing. You must have noticed that majority of the cases of somebody developing a catch or getting sprained happens early in the morning. Why? Because we have not done any physical activity and will put some demand. Maybe you're just going to pick up your suitcase and put it in the luggage compartment of your train, and that is the time you'll get a stretch here. So wake up your body early in the morning. It'll keep on functioning the whole day after you've done that. But that early morning thing is not good enough for the whole day. It doesn't mean that you can keep on sitting the whole day. Even during the daytime, whenever you can find time, you must go out, you must be physically active. The simple act of getting up from your chair itself would do a lot of good. So you have to keep your body in motion on a constant basis. Only then would you be able to function properly all the time. All the best.